So, you've been saving up money for months, and finally, you have invested yourself into a new gaming system you also would like to stream on. First of all, welcome to the PC Master Race. You created your Twitch account, gave it a good or a funny name, but right now you're struggling how to set up your streaming software. Well, I'm here to help you. Hey, what is up, guys? My name is Carsten, and I'm your stream daddy for today, and I'm going to help you set up Streamlabs OBS. Streamlabs OBS is like OBS Studio that allows you to broadcast your content live to Twitch, YouTube, and Facebook. Overall, Streamlabs is pretty easy to use and set up with all the integration tools that they provide: custom overlays, widgets, and alerts. And those things will make sure that your stream will stand out. The main scene we're focusing on is on your gameplay scene and your intermission screen. The gameplay scene is meant for you playing games with friends, with the viewers, or even alone. Maybe narrating your gameplay, tell them what you're going to do, or tell them what you're about to do, and create some unforgettable moments. The intermission scene is the scene where you talk with your audience, with your viewers, asking them how their day were, what I've been up to, discussing some stuff, or even discussing some ideas for your YouTube channel or some games that they want to see you play. The intermission screen is also the scene where I like to spend most of my time in. The goal of this video is to help you understand the program and learn how to set it up so you can start making content. Are you ready? Let's get to it then. The first thing we're going to do is going to the website streamlabs.com. Once you arrive at the website, you will see a download button right there. Click on the download button and it will ask you to install it. Click on save file, and right now it is downloading the file. Wait until it gets downloaded and then we can move on. Once you have downloaded Streamlabs and open it up, this is the first screen that you will see. It is asking you right now which platform do you want to stream to. The platform we are going to focus on is Twitch for right now, so what you want to do is click on the Twitch icon right there, wait for it to load, then it will come up with a new pop-up screen. Log in with your Twitch username and your password, and you should be good from there. Once you're logged in, Streamlabs will ask you, do you want to import from OBS? If you have used OBS before, then you can import all your scenes, the widgets, the alerts, straight into Streamlabs. If you haven't, click on Start Fresh. The thing that we are going to do right now is starting from fresh and work our way up from there. But the thing what you want to do right now, click on Start Fresh, and right now it is waiting for you to set up your things. It is asking for your microphone, your webcam. It is going to ask for the basic things. Right now, we're going to skip it. And the reason why we're skipping, we're going to set up all the things by ourselves. The first screen we're getting greeted to is if you want to add a theme to your stream. Like, do you want to use some free overlays that they will provide for you, which you can use for free? The thing that we're going to do, I have my own overlay that is made from a designer that I know. We're going to use it. I will show you guys how to set it up. You can use everything to it. If you want to use a free overlay that streamers will provide, then click on one thing that you will like. Let's say, for example, Relative Minds. The moment we skipped it, it is asking us for start and optimize. Click on the start button. It is going to optimize your possibilities, testing your bandwidth, and see on what bitrate or what settings you can stream on. So, when you have done all the steps, this is the first thing that you will see right now. You will see your scenes on the left bottom. You will see your sources, your mixer, and also your mini feed for when people follow you, subscribe to you, donate, or share bits to you. The first thing we're going to focus on is the settings. What you want to do, on the left bottom corner, you will see a small setting wheel. Click on there, and then you will see a window pop up for you. The first thing we're going to do is go to video and set your resolution. The resolution I'm going for is 1920 by 1080. That is the resolution I stream at. For most people, they will start streaming at 720p, so the resolution that I recommend for you guys is 1280 by 720. Go to your downscale filter and make sure it is set to long scale sharpening scaling 32 samples. Common FPS, put it on 60. We like a smooth stream. If you cannot run 60 FPS, click on it and put it on 30 FPS. I will keep it on 60. The next thing we're going to is going to your output. Click on output right there and put your output mode to advanced. Don't get scared though, it is not really that difficult. The first thing we're going to do is go to our encoder right here, and we're going to put it on hardware NVENC new if you have an NVIDIA graphics card. If you have AMD, look up online and see what the best setting is for you. The rate control will be on CBR, and because we're going to set up our stream in 720p, the bitrate I recommend maximum for 720p is 4500. If you want to stream on 1080p, 6500 is the maximum I will go to. Most streams will recommend 6000. I recommend 6500. I like the little bit of leeway, and sometimes the quality can dip down under the 6500. With 6500, it looks a bit sharper than 6000 in my experience. Once you have done all those things, the preset can be on quality. If you run into some issues like lagging, for example, then put it one lower to performance. We'll keep it on quality. That's the settings. That was it. This first scene we are getting greeted to is the normal scene right here. Let's rename the scene by right clicking on the scene, and let's rename it to intermission screen. Also, the two main screens we're going to focus on is on your intermission screen and your gameplay screen. So right now you can also add in the other one, your gameplay screen. What you want to do is go to the plus sign right there where your scenes are, click on it and name your new scene. Also, small tip, let's rename our scenes again and put F1 and F2 behind our scenes. I will tell you shortly why we are going to do this. So, right now at the intermission screen, the things that you want to add in, it all depends on you and what you have though. I have my own design, so I'm going to show you how I add my own designs in there. What you want to do is go to sources, click on the plus sign, and we're going to media source. My intermission screen is an animated scene. That means if I add it in as a picture, it is static. That's why we want to add it in as a media source, because it's an animated scene. Click on add source, and let's call this the intermission screen. So right now it is asking for you to find your file. Click on browse, search up for your file that you want to use for your intermission screen, and add it in. Once you have added in your intermission screen, make sure you enable this setting right here, the loop setting. Animations can last for 10 or 20 seconds. You want to make sure they keep on playing. Otherwise, after 20 seconds, 30 seconds, for how long the animation is set to, it will cut off and there's a black screen then. Also, with the UIFI color range, you can keep it on auto. We don't have to do any settings right there. And that is your intermission screen added in. It still looks pretty blank, doesn't it? So the next thing we're going to do, Ron, is adding in our text and adding in our text box. The textbook will make sure when your viewers are typing too, it will display it right there under the live chat on screen. So if someone types, hello, how are you doing? Want to play a game? You will see it right there, and slowly it adds up the more people there will be in the chat. The first thing you need to do to add in your chat box is go to the sources and click on the plus sign. Then hover yourself over to the chat box, which is right there on the widget section. Click on add source. And let's name this live chat. The thing what I like to do most, because you will see right there that is the scene of the chat box. So let me move this a bit more to the side so you guys won't see it right now. And let me drag it over there, right in the middle. So instead of dragging the chat box bigger or smaller, or hold it with Alt and make it smaller like this, the things that will happen is your text will cut out. So you won't see most of the text, or the text will get bigger or smaller and gets really pixelated. So the text will get unsharp. The thing what I like to do the most is, let's get back this screen. You see the width and height right there. Change it out until it fully fits in. Let's say, for example, the width we will do 400. You see right now it is getting way and way smaller. We still need to put in a little bit of height. Let's say, for example, 750. You have to play around with these settings a little bit to really fit it in into your live chat. If you don't have an intermission with a live chat, then you can do however you will like it and set it up from there. There we go. These are my settings, and if someone types in chat right now, it does look pretty decent, doesn't it? Like, the text is still pretty small, but also really high quality, so it won't be really hard to read. And also it's not getting pixelated because he stretched it out so much. The next thing we're going to do right now is adding in our text up there. You see my Instagram logo, a Twitter logo, and a YouTube logo, but we still need some text added in there. So the next thing we want to do is go to the source again and click on the plus sign. Then go to the section text, GDI plus, click on add source. Let's name this our Instagram one, so we know that this text will be right there at Instagram. Add in the source, and then right there, the thing what I will recommend to you guys is don't use a standard font. go with a custom one. Font that I can recommend is Passion One. Then fill it out in your text. Now, while in my Instagram is named Carlsdeist, you can also transform your text, so it'd be uppercase or only lowercase, only a start case. I like to do the start case, like the big capital letter at the beginning. It looks way better. You can also change out the color, change out the opacity, like how bright must it be or like how dark must it be. The background color. You can also add a gradient to the text by enabling the gradient setting right there and click on the gradient color. You will see like it adds a little gradient to the text, right? Like red on the bottom, white on top, and you can also rotate it. You see the difference? Now there's more red on the left side and more white on the right side. With these things, you really want to get creative with your intermission, with your game. It's going to get creative to make sure it really stands out the most for you. Play with it a little bit, get a little bit creative. Once you have added in everything, your text, your chat box as well. Next step we're going to do is setting up your webcam. The thing what you want to do is go to the sources, click on the plus sign and go to the section that is called video capture device. Click on that one and click on add source and name your webcam. My webcam is a Logitech Brio. I'm going to name it to the Brio. So right now you will get open this scene and your webcam will slowly load in. If it doesn't, click on devices and click on your capture device. Click on your camera, click on your webcam or any other capture device that you use. Right now, our stream is set up to be 720p. So I also set up my webcam to 1280 by 720 at 60 FPS because the Logitech Brio can go to 1080 60 or 4K 30 FPS. So what you want to do is go to custom, then pick out the resolution, which will be for me 1280 by 720. Then we're going to 60 FPS. We can leave that one to any color space. I like to have some full color space instead of the default. It gives a bit more accuracy in colors as well. Go to color range full, and that is all the settings we need. So right now, my webcam is right in front of it. You can see, so like all the bars sticking out. It doesn't fit in well with the intermission screen yet. So let's make it a little bigger. Just by dragging that, let's make it a little bigger. And a thing you want to do right now is, if you look at your sources, you want to think as a sandwich. You have the bottom of the bread and your salad, maybe some meat, then the cheese, then something else. Think about it as a sandwich. The thing you want to do is put in your webcam under your intermission screen. And right now it will fit in with all the corners around it. So the next thing we're going to do right now is making groups. We're going to make sure that everything in the sources, everything will look clean because we don't want to have a whole list of all the things we've added in. Like we only want to see a small part of it, like all the things that we might need to change out. So let's make a group right now. Go to the sources and next to the plus sign on the left, you will see a group. Click on that one and let's name this one socials. This will done for all the text above right here. You have the folder right there. Make sure to drag in all the text widgets into the socials folder. If you open up the folder run, you will see all those things in there. If you close it, it looks way cleaner. It looks way and way more cleaner right now. Also, the next thing we're going to do is adding our microphone and our background sound. Go to sources, click on the plus sign and go to audio input capture. Let's name it the same name as my microphone, which is a Blue Yeti, and in the source and go to device. It stands on default right now. I will go to microphone Yeti stereo. That is my microphone I'm using right now. I will click on that one, add it as a source. And right now your stream can hear your microphone and the way that you talk. We're still not done with the audio yet. Go to source again and click on the plus sign. And this time we're going to audio output capture. Click on that one and let's name it our background sounds. This will pick up all the sounds like your music, your gameplay, or even your teammates. Click on add source and we're going to device and go to the, well, mostly what I like to say is pick up the thing from your headset. So that's what I'm going to do right now. My headset is an Arctic Steel Series 7. Click on that one, click on done. And right now what I hear through my headset is what the stream as well will hear right now. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to clean up our mixer a little bit because there's a lot of things which we don't use. So right now, the thing that you want to do is mute all of them and then hide them away. That is my background sounds. We don't hide that one. We're going to hide the live chat, hide the intermission because those things don't make any sound or like they don't record any sound. So why should we have them there in the mixer? The only two things we mainly need is our background sound and our microphone. So right now that's all cleaned up. Let's make one more group for the audio. Click on the group icon again, left of the plus sign in the sources. And let's name this folder our audio. Make the group and make sure to drag in your background sound and your Blue Yeti. And right now our intermission screen is done. Let's go on to the gameplay screen. Right now we're at the gameplay screen and let's add in all those things again. Let's start off with the background sound, which is go to sources, go to audio output capture, click on add source and it's already there. You can copy it, click on add source and right now we have the background sound. Let's also do the microphone real quick. Sources, click on the plus sign, go to audio input capture, click on add source and you also will see it right there. Put it in and now we have the audio fixed for our gameplay screen. The next thing we're going to do is adding in our game. So right now the thing that you want to do is open up your game first. Once you have your game loaded up, make sure to click on your keyboard on Alt tab and go back to the Streamlabs. Go to sources on the plus sign right now and make sure to add it in as a game capture. You can add it in as a display capture, but a game capture one, it will run a bit lighter than a normal screen capture and the overall frame rate of recording it is way and way smoother than the display capture can handle. Click on the game capture, click on add source, and let's name this Fall Guys because that is the game that I want or wish to record right now. Right now you will see this screen right there. You can put it on auto so it will take on any game that you want open. What I like to do mostly is go to capture specific window, click on the window which is the Fall Guys client, put it right there, and I like to put my hook rate on fast. What does that mean, the hook rate? The hook rate means when you go from one scene to the other, it loads in immediately. If you put it on slow, then you'll see like a black screen for like 2-3 seconds before it loads in and opens up on your stream. Once you have all of those set up, click on done, and you have the game added in. From this moment, we don't have to do much more things. The next thing we're going to do is add in our webcam and add in our webcam overlay. So first, go to sources, go to video capture device, and make sure to add in the webcam. Right now you see my webcam, so I'm going to scale it down to size. There we go, that looks pretty good. One thing to notice, you can see my webcam overlay right there. It has some weird cutouts right now. The way we can manage those cutouts is by adding a mask to the webcam. Right click on your webcam source, go to filters, click on the plus sign right there. And right now the thing that we want to do is add in a mask so we can get those weird cutouts. Think about it as a pizza slicer. You have your pizza which is a circle and you slice a corner off or like a pizza point of it. That is the same thing we're going to do with a mask. Click on done, and then I'm going to browse for the mask right now. Once you have added your mask, make sure to set it as Alpha Mask Alpha Channel instead of Color Channel. Otherwise, you will see black screen and you don't see your webcam at all. Let's click on done, and that is my corners added in. The next thing we want to do is add in our media source, add in our webcam overlay because it's an animated overlay. You want to add it in as a media source. Let's go to media source, click on add source and browse for the file. We're going to add a new source instead. Let's name this one as our webcam overlay. We're going to add in the source and right now browse for the source. Make sure to enable the loop function so it doesn't cut off after like 10 or 20 seconds. Click on done and that is our webcam source. How do you line those up perfectly right now? What I like to do is make sure that my webcam is big. I can really see all the details and make sure that everything is lined up perfectly. Right now, we're going to make a group and the group will give us some benefits. Make sure to go to the group folder and let's name it our webcam folder. Click on done. And right now you want to drag in your Logitech Brio webcam and your webcam overlay into the same folder. What does this allow you to do? If I want to drag it right now or make it smaller or bigger, it does it all at the same moment. And there we go. There's our webcam overlay added in to our stream. Also, don't forget about making a folder for your audio. Get those sources a bit empty out and make sure it's clean and manageable for you. So, right now we're going to work on our transition that is from one scene to the other scene. So, let's go to the scenes and click on the settings rule right there. And you can set your transition. Click on the edit side. We can go for a cut. We can go for a fade, a swipe, a slide, a fade to color. A Luma swipe, a motion or a stinger. Stinger is actually where you can make your own custom transition or adding your own custom transitions. I already have a custom one, so I'm going to Stinger. I'm going to browse for my file right now. And right now, if I would swipe between my scenes, we still need to time it perfectly. So let's get back to the settings rule under the scenes. Click on edit and let's fill out a time where it will switch over perfectly. Let's say, for example, 200 milliseconds. Let's see how it will look like. Almost. We almost managed to do it. So let's add it up to 400 milliseconds. We almost did it. Just a bit more. Just tweak it out a little bit. Once you figure out the timing and make sure the effing looks clean, also transitions over really clean. So we can close it right now. And we're going to preview it and see if everything looks right. That all looks pretty decent to me. So we're going back to the gameplay screen. And right now we still want to add in our alert box. Go to the sources. Then go to the widgets that says the alert box. Click on the add source. Whenever someone follows you, subscribes to you, donates to you, they will see a alert on screen. Right now, if you look at this screen, it looks like a lot of things are right there, but it's actually pretty simple. So I will walk you through the steps. Let's say, for example, I'm going to edit my follow alert. If you want to change out the title message, like for example, the name or like the text behind it, the font size, you can do it right there. If you go to the media, then you can change out the alert itself by clicking on change media. If you have a special custom sound you want to add to it, then you can also do it from there and manage the volume. So for example, if someone follows me right now, they will see the follow alert, the name will be there, and there we go. That's how you set up your alert box. Right now we are done up setting up your stream. Your stream is all set up. There we go. Wasn't that difficult, wasn't it? The things that you can still add in is your starting soon screen, your be your back screen, your ending screen, and make sure that everything is lined up perfectly and all looks pretty well. With those screens, you can use the same tactics that we use for the intermission screen and for the gameplay screen, making sure the alert box is in there, the text, if you have like an Instagram, Twitter, or a YouTube logo in your starting soon screen, and make sure everything goes well and blend in very well with your stream. If this video sucked, then you know what to do, but if you think the video was awesome, drop a like, drop a subscribe, maybe ring those notification bells on, and if you have learned anything, let me know down in the comments. I also stream on Monday, Wednesday, Fridays, links down in the description. Make sure to join in. Let's have a talk about like stream software, audio gear, or whatever. You're joining my chat. Let's have a chat with each other, okay? And as always, good luck streaming.